So this is a story, you know, that you have already come to know, that Miss Minchin seminary. There was Miss Minchin seminary, and in the seminary many girls came to study, and Sarah was one of them. And Sarah was considered very special by Miss Minchin, because Miss Minchin thought that Sarah would become an heiress, and as she would be becoming very rich. And as a result, Sarah was considered very special by Miss Minchin, and Miss Minchin always tried to pay every attention to Sarah. But Sarah was not like that. Sarah was very friendly to others. Sarah was very friendly to everyone. Sarah liked everyone's company. And Sarah tried to remain as simple as everyone, and she used to mix with everyone. But Miss Minchin always tried to separate her out by saying that she would be an heiress, she would be doing something, she was very special, she would be become very much wealthy. These type of things she always tried to mention to the others, the girls in the seminary. And it was Sarah's birthday party, so Becky wanted to stay there. Sarah asked for permission, and Miss Minchin also gave a speech on Sarah's favors. At that time, Sarah felt uncomfortable because she wanted to remain friendly with others. Now, at that time, Sarah thanked everyone for being present in the party. And very pretty indeed, Sarah approved Miss Minchin. This is the third part starting, I'm starting. Miss Minchin also approved, means appreciated Sarah's behavior, that how Sarah could thank everyone. And that a real princess does when people applaud her. So according to her, a real princess usually has such good manners. When people applaud her, she usually acknowledges the praising. Now I will leave you to enjoy yourselves. She said that you should now enjoy them yourselves. The instant she had swept out of the room, the girls jumped or tumbled out of the seats. So the moment she had gone out of the room, the girls, what did they do? They jumped or tumbled out of their seats. Means they were just jumping out of the seats. They were tumbling, means they were coming, forcibly coming out of the seats. It means while coming out, it seemed that they would be falling down. You know what you do usually in your friends' birthday parties. How do you enjoy? You jump, you sing, you dance, you gossip, you you make the most of the situation. Similarly, the girls were doing. As soon as Miss Minchin went out, means they got a chance to enjoy themselves, there was a rush towards the boxes. So all the girls rushed towards the boxes. Sarah had bent over one of them with a delighted face. She turned to the biggest box. Now Sarah bent over one of them, and it was the biggest box. And she turned to the biggest box. It was very nice when she took out the last doll. It was so magnificent that the children uttered delighted groans of joy. So when she took out the last doll from the box, and it was very magnificent, extremely beautiful. And the children, when they saw the doll, they were so surprised. They were so delighted. They were so happy. They just shouting loudly. They were expressing their happiness through joy. Their happiness through shouting, cheering, everything. She is almost as big as Luti, someone gasped. So someone opened, she was so surprised that she was taking her breath with an open mouth. And she said that she is almost as big as Luti. Luti means another girl, so the girl was as big as Luti. Luti clapped her hands and danced about gleefully. And Luti was also very happy that she was compared to a doll, and she was clapping her hands and she was dancing about gleefully. She is dressed for the theater, said Lavinia. Lavinia also described that she was so beautifully dressed. That means, she seemed to be dressed for what? Theater. Oh, cried Ermengarde, darting forward. She has an opera glass in her hand. So Ermengarde was another girl. She ran towards the doll to see. And she just sat down. She has an opera glass in her hand. So it was a sort of smaller pair of binoculars. Means when she saw the doll, she was excited to see that the doll was having a pair of binoculars. Here is a trunk, said Sarah. She sat down upon the floor and turned the key. So here is the trunk, and she said Sarah. Sarah said that there is a trunk, and then she sat upon the floor and then turned the key. The children crowded, clamoring round, and she lifted tray after tray and revealed their contents. The children were crowding, they were making confused noise. They and Why? Because they were so happy, so excited to see Sara's gifts, presents. And Sara was taking tray after tray, and she was just showing everything to everyone. The revealing the contents, means whatever was there in the tray, she was trying to show that. Never had the schoolroom been in such an uproar. So never, this type of shouting never went on in that schoolroom, particularly in that classroom, but never went on. But inside the school at that particular point of time, due to Sara's birthday, Miss Minchin allowed everyone to join the party. So there was huge confusion, huge shouting, and huge excitement going on. There were lace collars and silk stockings. There was a jewel case containing a necklace. If usually girls, you have already seen that when you play with Barbie, how Barbie has special dresses according to her character, how Barbie is has special things given with the wrappers of the Barbie doll. Similarly, this doll also has what? Lace collars, then lace means collars with beautiful decoration of laces. Then silk stockings it has. There was a jewel case, means it had a jewel case containing necklace. There were dresses of all kinds, means usually the girls use particular dresses, ornaments and everything. Similarly, the doll was means dressed like that. Acha, there were dresses of all kinds. There were hats and tea gowns and fans. Suppose, Sara said as she stood by the table, putting a large black velvet hat on the table. On the doll, suppose she understands human talk and feels proud of being admired. So at that time, suppose Sara said as she stood by the table, and she said she put on a large black velvet hat on the doll. And she tried to imagine, she tried to suppose that if human, we are so excited, we are appreciating the girl. If suppose if the doll would have understood our language, our words. There were hats, figures. Suppose she understands human talk and feels proud of being admired. She might be singing the human, she might be feeling very proud of being admired. Okay, you are always supposing things, said Lavinia, and her tone was very superior. Now, at that time, Lavinia criticized rather. Lavinia criticized whom? Lavinia criticized Sara, that you are always supposing things. Means you are trying to imagining means to imagine every type of thing. This means you are always thinking that this should have happened, this would have happened. Why? And her tone means she was in a very serious tone, this type of thing she said, Lavinia said. I know I am, said Sara undisturbedly. There is nothing so nice as supposing. So Sara said yes, she had a habit of supposing, and supposing means imagining. So she, there is no nothing so nice. Means always if you imagine, means someone, imagine someone is visiting another land. It is very nice. Means one ever, whoever tries to live in the world of imagination, he is living in another world. Yeah, or she is living in another world and they are enjoying themselves. Now, so if you suppose anything hard enough, it seems, it's almost like being a fairy. If you suppose anything hard enough, it seems as if it is very real. So according to Sara, it's like fairy. Fairy wishes everything. Fairy wishes everything, and fairy wish make the wishes successful. Similarly, if someone imagines, it seems that it is a fairy wish granting her wishes, and it's absolutely remarkable to be in the world of supposing or imagination. And it seemed that when a hardcore imagination takes place, it seemed that everything to be real.